What is up, guys? It's your favorite island beep. First off, I need you to like, comment, and subscribe, and tell everybody or their moms to subscribe to my channel because it gets litty like a mother effing titty. So today is Deep Talks episode 4. I have some special guests today, different age groups. I decided to do different age groups because I think it's better to have a different mindset, different scenarios, different, school-like experiences. Today's episode is about motivation and self-confidence. My first guest here today is... Tell them your name and tell them your age and yep.
Okay, well, hi, my name is Tenora, and my age is 11.
Okay, tell them what grade you're in.
I'm in fifth grade right now.
So, what is self-confidence to you? What is having a lot of confidence?
A lot of confidence to me, I think it means that, like, you have a lot of faith in yourself.
Okay, maybe you have a bunch of ideas and then the people around you are like, oh, that's ugly, like that's trash, why would you like that? Would you change your mind or would you still like stuff because you like it, or are you just gonna go with the crowd?
I would still like it if I like it, because no one's gonna tell me what to like and what not to like.
Okay, so why are you like that? What are your goals?
My goals is to teach my friends to not be followers, but to be leaders.
What is some advice for fifth graders and below?
If you are in fifth grade and below, usually people inside your class would tell you, like, I didn't ask you, or they would tell you that that's, like, not a good thing to like, and what they'll tell you what to like and not what to like. So just don't listen to them. Just be yourself, because God loves you for who you are.
Oh. Okay. Now sit down. Tell them what your name is and tell them your age and tell them what grade you're in.
Okay. Hey, everybody. My name is Morley.
Try to look at this.
I am 15 and I am single. I'm also in high school. What? I'm a sophomore.
Is there a lot of followers in high school?
Oh, yeah. There's a lot of... Everyone's always looking up to someone. And in high school, it's more of like... people just trying to find themselves, mostly. Or if they already know what they are, or not what they are, what they're trying to go for, then people are just trying to go for that. But it's either one of two things. It's either you're going for what you want to go for, or people are just figuring it out in their life right now.
What if people say that your dreams are dumb?
Oh, I don't pay any attention to them. I don't really pay attention to people who say negative things about me, unless they're remarks that can help me, like feedback that can help me grow.
Like what?
Like
what's an example?
Say somebody says, I tell them that I'm gonna go be an astronaut. If somebody says, like, oh, you're never gonna make it, oh, you're bad, oh, you're not trained enough, or you're not gonna make it, that I don't listen to. But if someone says something like, it's gonna take a lot of hard work and perseverance and a lot of studying, you know, and a lot of training, physical training as well, and I need to be prepared for that, then I'll take in their advice. Because, I mean, it doesn't sound like they're trying to bring me down, but more of like trying to give me a reality check.
Okay. Do you think closed-minded people can be motivated? Like, they can have a lot of motivation?
Yeah, but it's going to be a lot harder.
So, is there anything you want to tell the people out there? All the high school people.
Oh. Your life's only going up. It's not going down right now. It's only going up. So look forward to your peak.
The reason why I'm in a different room is because they weren't here in the beginning because TJ was sleeping, which is this man. Introduce yourself. Tell him.
Hello. I'm about to graduate high school. I am 17. And that's it, right?
Obviously, that means he's a senior in high school. So like I was telling you in the beginning of this video, I decided to get different age groups and different grades, obviously, because that comes with age. So he's obviously going to transfer, like transition from high school to college. What does being self-motivated mean?
So the question I'm answering is, what is being self-motivated?
Correct, sir.
Okay. So I feel like self-motivation is more like giving yourself reasons to do something. That's what I view self-motivation as. So like, for example, you could be self-motivated to become a doctor. So with reasons could be like the salary, or you just love helping people out. So the steps you need to take is like taking medical classes or volunteering at like the hospitals.
Like, do you need people to support you to be motivated, or are you just motivated on your own?
You don't need people to be motivated, but it does definitely help to have other people to be there for you to help motivate you towards your own dreams. But I don't think you need people, though, to pursue your dreams. You can have your own motivation to keep you going towards your goals.
Okay, so what do you think about, like, what if you're around people and they're not as motivated as you? Will that bring down your vibe? So if your friends aren't as motivated and all they do is just sit down all day, and you're more of a, you know, like you're hungry for success and they're really more like, if success happens, fine. Do you think that could dictate your thought process? Like, you'll start, your thought process might change because of the people you surround yourself with?
I think it depends on the person, because it could go either way. If one person is really motivated and doing something and like going outdoors and everything, they can motivate the person who isn't as hyped up as them. Or it could be the other way around, where the person who isn't that motivated could affect the person who's trying to
do better
in their own lives. So I feel like it could go both ways. It just depends on the person.
What about being confident? Do you think being confident has to do with being motivated? Do you need to be a confident person to have self-motivation? Like, do you have to believe in yourself? Do you have to be confident in your body, your goals, your anything like that to be motivated? Or can you be, like, insecure and still be motivated?
You do need to be confident in order to pursue that motivation, because I feel like they work hand in hand together. You can't be motivated and not do anything about it, because the whole point of motivation is like a fuel for you to go towards a certain goal you want to achieve.
Okay, so what do you have to tell everybody that is in high school that's about to go into a new chapter of their life? What's some advice that you would give people that are in high school, that are seniors about to graduate?
So if you're still unsure about what you want to do in life, because I know there is a lot of people out there who do know what to do with their lives, or are expected to, due to social norm, to know what they want to do with their lives after high school, but there is people who don't know after that specific point. It just takes some time. You can process all of that in your own time. You don't need to try to rush it after high school. Just do you.
Okay, guys. Now I have another special guest, and here she is.
Hello.
Oh my gosh. Okay, tell them your name and tell them your grade and whatever you're doing right now, like your situation.
My name's Alexis. I'm her baby sister. I'm 22 years old. I attend UC Irvine. This was totally unplanned. I was already sleeping in this.
Okay, whatever.
Okay, but yeah, I'm a double major in chemistry and public health sciences, and that's pretty much it.
Okay, tell them your grade.
I'm currently about to graduate. Well, I'm supposed to graduate in June, but you all know what's going on.
Okay, tell them what you think motivation is.
Motivation to me is just that sense of urge that one person has that pushes them to kind of like achieve whatever goals or dreams that they set forth for themselves.
Stay self-motivated when your parents tell you that your goals aren't good.
That's something that I actually still kind of have like a hard time with, but I just kind of try to voice whatever they say out of my head and still kind of just think about like the goal that I have for myself. And the goal that I actually set for myself, I still push myself, even though some of the things that they can say towards me is very negative. You just have to try to turn the negativity into like a push to kind of just get to where you need to be.
Like, you need people to support you to make it.
I was taught that you need people to kind of support you. I was taught two things, actually, that you either need someone to support you, and then when you kind of go based off that, they kind of switch it up and say that you don't need someone to support you to, you know, get to where you need to be. So I'm a little bit confused, but now since I kind of just took that step back and learned things for myself in a way, I realized that you don't need someone to support you. You just need yourself, because at the end of the day, when people go up and they leave you or they're not by your side, how do you expect to support yourself? You just can't go and pull somebody and be like, support me now. I need support. That's where you need to kind of just rely on yourself. Independent.
Okay, do you think that the people that you surround yourself with dictate your thought process?
I do strongly believe that.
Why? Did it happen to you?
It has happened to me, and happened is a past, and I should use happens. It's happened and happened. And it does really do dictate your life. So, as cliche as it may sound, the people that you surround yourself with do sort of have an effect on you, so...
Choose wisely, people.
Yeah, definitely choose wisely. I totally recommend that.
What is that advice for college people?
I say that when you go to college, do things that you truly want to do for yourself. And it's never too late. I didn't start doing things for myself until I was really, really late, but... sometimes, like we said earlier, you don't need someone to always like be there by your side, but it's all about self-motivation. So have the self-motivation, have the confidence in yourself, and remember that we're still growing and we grow every single day, and not everybody is perfect. And also, another word of advice, shout out to my big sister for this, never be afraid to make mistakes. Never fear of mistakes or failure, because those lead to experiences that is only going to help you progress as an individual.
To share your motivation with them.
And what if they don't get up? Then just let them find it on their own?
If they don't get motivated? I just think that you would just need to, at a scenario like that, you would just need to push. Like, keep motivating them, keep doing your part. But at the end of the day, it's all up to that person.
Okay. And okay, guys. This is what I was trying to tell you. I'm trying to tell you guys that at the end of the day, you can motivate somebody so much, and if they're not going to put in the time or the effort, you cannot help somebody that doesn't want to be helped. And if they say they want to be helped and you're out there trying to help them and they're still not moving, that you're motivating them, you're giving them all the tools, you're giving them everything, and all they need to do is put in a little extra work and they're not doing it, you just can't. Like, at the end of the day, it has to do with the person. They're going to get motivated on their own, whatever motivates them or not. Some people just glow all day and they just take their day by day, wasting their days. And staying, just not doing anything to utilize their time. When it comes to confidence, do you want to get in the frame? Scoot over a little bit. Okay, sorry. We're gonna put Tenora in the frame because we're about to cut this video. We're about to cut this. And when it has to do with self-confidence,
having a lot of self-confidence has to do with being motivated. If you're not confident in yourself, you're not confident in your goals, you're not confident in your body, you're not confident in the way you're doing your paths in life, you're not confident in general. In order to be confident, some things that you could take into precaution is stop comparing yourself to other people. I don't know why people compare themselves. I'm not sure. If you go to the gym and you're saying that you want to be big like that person, or you want to be skinny, or you want to look like this person on Instagram, or you want to be that person buying all this Gucci and have all the drip, then I'm not sure. I just go out there and do it yourself. If you want to lose weight, go lose weight. If you want to get big, go get big. Time is ticking in these streets, guys. Time is ticking.
Well, but I think looking up to other people is not too bad. I don't think you should degrade yourself because of it.
Yes,
like you should you should set up a goal for yourself. Always look up to different people, because if you do, it'll motivate yourself. But at the same time, it could also hurt you, because say like I want to be fit like what's his face, Aquaman.
Oh my gosh. Bruh. Okay.
I can look up to him, you know. I can like work out and everything, but then I might one day look at myself and be like, oh, I'll never be as good as him. But I mean, I think that's where we have to stop thinking like that kind of mindset, like we're not as good, because we're good. Like, you know, y'all are beautiful. We're all beautiful in our own way, and if you want to strive to be better, then you can strive to be better, but just don't degrade yourself because it defeats the whole purpose.
People are too hard on themselves these days. Take it easy. If I'm at the gym and then all of a sudden after the gym I eat Krispy Kreme donuts, I'm not going to be sitting all sad because I ate Krispy Kreme donuts. You know, I'm pretty sure everybody has fallbacks, but I'm not going to beat myself down because I chose to eat a Krispy Kreme donut. That's all I'm just trying to say. You shouldn't be getting sad or it's not working, my gym workouts aren't working, and then just be sad for days. Just try to find a solution, try to find ways to work and being motivated. You don't need people, guys, when it comes to motivation, you don't need people to believe in you. You need to believe in you. Because everybody else can believe in me, and if I don't believe in myself, then I'm never gonna move. I'm never gonna get up off my bed. I'm never gonna go do what I need to do, go chase my goals, unless I believe in myself. My whole family can believe in me, and if I still don't believe in me, I'm not gonna give it 100% because I don't believe in myself. And that has to do with being confident. You need to be confident. Forget it. And if I'm doing something and people don't believe in me, I could care less. Because at that point, I believe in myself and I'm going to give it 100% regardless. And then if people don't want to ride for you too with your goals and they're always dogging you about stuff like that, you don't need that type of negativity. Just keep it pushing, guys. Keep it pushing. Keep it moving. At the end of the day, it just depends on what you... Just cut off all the negativity. It doesn't matter who it is, guys. It could be your... It could be your husband, your wife, your family. If they're giving you negative vibes and they're talking trash on your dreams, you don't need that. Just exclude them.
But don't confuse it with encouragement, or don't confuse it with reality check.
Yes, and then people, we're gonna keep I need to say this. Some of these people out here in these streets are too soft. You guys are too soft out here. If someone's trying to help you and they're giving you criticism, right, and they're telling you you're doing something wrong. So if I'm squatting on the bench, we're gonna use the gym again, if I'm squatting and my form is wrong and I get mad and I'm just like, why are you telling me what to do? Why are you telling me about squatting? You don't know anything. That's just like, dude.
Well, that goes you back.
Yeah, like you're not gonna move forward because you can't take criticism. If you cannot take criticism from somebody else, you have some serious issues. Like you need to take a step back and start reevaluating your life, because sometimes people take criticism negative, and it's not always negative. People are trying to help you, so take the help.
Failing is going to be a big part of where you're trying to go. A lot of feeling. And I mean, I don't think most people know that. I think when they go to do stuff, they think that there won't be a lot of downs. And so just remember, there's going to be a lot, and I mean a lot of downs. But I mean, the more you fall, and the more you fail, is the closer you could get to your dream.
I don't know what it is. Sometimes people don't think that you're going to fail and stuff. Or even if you fail, they start gloating again. Gloating means, if you guys don't know, is like, I never do anything right. I just don't do anything right. I always fail at everything. Nothing ever works my way. Nothing's working out for me. Everything bad happens to me. Just stuff like that is like gloating. Why? You're wasting your time saying all this stuff and degrading yourself just because you made a mistake. Just get over it. Move forward. You want to make mistakes in these streets. Is again, the self-criticism. I know a lot of people that can't. They just can't. Like, they think that everyone's out to get them because they're correcting them. But you should try to listen to these people, because if they're trying to give you criticism, that means that they care. They care for you. They're trying to help you. If you can't take self-criticism, or someone's trying to help you and they're criticizing what you're doing, but they're doing it in a good way, then you need a reality check, because I'm not trying to be negative, but you can't make it in life like that. Not being open-minded, listening to people correct you. You should be happy, but not a lot of people are like that. I'm not really sure why.
Ego plays in that.
Yeah, it does. That means you have big ego, ego issues. If you cannot take criticism, your ego is too big. And if your ego is too big, you can't be in no relationship. You guys better not be in no love life relationships if your ego's too big, because relationships take two people. If someone has a big ego, it's just never gonna work. You guys are always gonna get in arguments, blah, blah, blah. You're gonna have problems at work. You're gonna have problems working in a team scenario. You can't be in a team when your ego is just out the door, and no one's gonna wanna be around you. And having big ego is damaging, because when you make mistakes because your ego is so big, you start to gloat because you're not used to it. You're just like, everything I do is wrong. And it's because your ego is just so big. And you need to stay motivated in these streets. Stop comparing yourself. Take self-criticism. Move forward. Your life's not gonna be the worst life you ever had, because some people are like that. Just think, you are only going up from here, even if you're making mistakes. It's gonna be okay, guys. That's my motivational talks, guys.
Do you, boo.
Yes, do you. Stay motivated. Do what you want to do. Forget everybody that's giving you negative vibes. If you want to stay with that, then that's on you. You pick and choose who you want in your life, in your circle, so.
A positive times the negative always comes out of negative.
Tell him again. I had to think about it. Tell him again.
A positive times a negative always comes out negative.
Now, what is positive times positive?
It always comes out positive.
That's self-explanatory. In these streets. Yes. And you cannot help you cannot change someone that doesn't want to. You cannot change people. They have to want to change.
Yeah. You can only push them.
Yes, you can only push them, and you can only motivate someone so much and push them so much before you start getting drained and exhausted, because you're trying to motivate them and they're not moving. If they're not moving, then that's on them. You can't. Yeah. Okay, so I guess that's going to be it. These are my announcements. Scoot the legs. Okay, guys, these are my announcements. If you guys are out there and you guys are selling Coachella tickets, hit me up on my line, Instagram, Snapchat, hit me up. I'm looking for 6 Coachella tickets. If you guys are going, if you guys aren't going, I'm just trying to be ahead of the game and already have my tickets before October. Everything else, I'm not really sure what's going on. Stay safe out there. Try to stay healthy in these streets. Tell them bye. I'm out of here. Bye.